reach out with your emotions. Let them guide you. Yes, that's it. Shara, tell me, what did you see?
It was you. You were in a jungle. Roots and vines, they took you, bound you, and then you were torn apart.
You saw the future. One of many possible futures, but a probable one at the very least.
Then I heard a voice. A woman, she reached out to me through the Force. She told me you had to go to Rishi.
Rishi? You said Rishi? Rishi's been coming up on the Nava computer. I thought it was some kind of glitch. Nothing out there but my kind of people.
That is no glitch. It is a message.
Let me guess. You're thinking of walking straight into a trap.
Perhaps it is a trap. What of it? Tell the crew there's been a change of schedule. I should very much like to visit this Rishi.
The rumors were true! You're here! You're really here!
You know me?
Oh, sure. I've heard you described in great detail. Great detail. You run the Howling Tempest Gang, the most daring, ruthless pirates of the Gordian Reach. Wherever that is.
I don't know what you think you've heard, but you're mistaken.
Nice try, but there's no mistake in the talk of the town. Seems like everyone in Raiders Cove is going on about you and all your insane adventures. Talk about your tough customers.
You're basic. It's very natural.
My people pick up languages and stuff real easy. Some of us like to be formal. I'm more of a cantina talk type. Speaking of cantinas, you'll want to watch for Goro. He wants to fight you so bad it's not even funny.
What's a Goro?
Rodian. With the eyes and ears and the snout. He's a supreme something or other, I forget. Really tough for his size. Goro's at the Blaster's Path, local watering hole. Probably washing down some Tonitron jerky with some Intellian fungo lager. I'm not allowed there anymore. Long story. So I hope someone hollows your big fight. Wouldn't want to miss a single bloody shot.
Ah!
I hear you're looking for me. Or someone who fits my description, at least.
Kastu undile, jigo hola lukuta.
Think you just did that yourself, Goro. Hang on. You're not about to wreck my place again, are you? I'm still filling in blaster holes.
Inigu daiji liska tsunangawa. Kusa malachikuta, ikosa mose alatuta.
No, this won't be a challenge at all. Not for me.
Chonki faguta, jiobora, jeoto kakise. Makipuna malituta, od mishka.
You may be seen as a hero on Rhodia, but compared to me.
You know, a few blaster marks is one thing. Gives the place some charm. But this...
You see before you a dark counselor of the Sith Empire. I should demand that you kneel. Instead, all I ask is that you give me the information I seek. Who is responsible for this ludicrous charade?
Everyone's talking about you. Couldn't tell you how it all got started, but I can tell you who gave Goro the idea to come after you.
Don't do it, Karina. You know what Margok would say about ratting out a resident?
If Margok ever pays the tab all you Nova Blades have run up, then maybe I'll start to care what he thinks. Guy you want is Kai Zyken, leader of the Corellian-run scoundrels. A real gem. Goro said Zyken owes you a pile of credits. He hired Goro to take you out for a fraction of what it would cost to pay you.
Where do I find him?
Beats me. It's not like I hang out with the guy. Ask Zyken's crew. They're all over Raider's Cove. Like stink flies.
I'm going to assume you're telling the truth. If I have to come back here, it won't be pleasant for you.
As opposed to all the pleasantness of this visit, right? Hey, I told you what I know. Best I can do. See you, Goro. Hope your brother doesn't decide this was my fault.
Well, look at this, scoundrels! A visit from...
Diabolka from Krida.
I was making a dramatic pause, Tomoda. I know it's the Hurling Tempest. Kai Zyken. I'm sure you've heard my name, most commonly accompanied by a longing sigh from one of my former conquests. Now here's the deal. The Corellian-run scoundrels may owe you a debt, but it's not coming out of my hide. Take it up with accounting.
I don't know where everyone got the idea I belong to some gang, but I'm sick of hearing it.
Wait, you're saying you're not... But that doesn't... Oh, you're just trying to confuse me.
Yakin Baba.
What? Was that a slam? Did you just slam me? Okay, alright. Listen, we can't pay. The freedom to operate in Raider's Cove isn't exactly free. After the Nova Blades take their cut, we're tapped. Not before you get an itch. I do have something of value. Something I know you want.
You tried to have me killed. I don't see why I shouldn't return the sentiment.
I get it! You're not happy with me. But you might be after this. I record all my holocalls, and that includes the one that warned me you were coming to Rishi. I'll show it to you. Tomoda! Get my data pad!
Lugusinobi chonki. Fakota ji oto endiha.
Oh, that's bad, Tomoda. That's bad. Oh, right! Yes, thank you, Tomoda! I knew there was a reason I kept you around. Here, you could find and unlock the case with this tracer, and you could even keep the data pad. How's that?
I'll take your data pad, but that doesn't mean I'm done with you.
Gotta hand it to you. The Whirling Tempest crew don't mess around. Right. That's what I said.
Kaizaikun, greetings. I speak to you now to deliver a warning. The Howling Tempest Gang is one of the galaxy's most feared pirate associations. They have just now set their sights on Rishi. As you know, the Corellian-run scoundrels owe the Howling Tempest Gang a great many credits. There is no telling what will happen when you are discovered. I suggest you herald the gang's arrival to draw unwanted attention on them. I'm dispatching several droids across Raiders Cove to do the same. Or you could do nothing and suffer the consequences. The choice is yours.
Greetings to you! Would you like to hear a true story about the legendary Howling Tempest Gang? Oh, I beg your pardon. I didn't realize it was you! How exciting. Such a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
You should consider yourself honored and fortunate to have this opportunity.
Indeed I do. My master did not prepare me for the sheer measure of awe I would be required to process. Why, in the time since your arrival, you have already defeated the illustrious Goro, brought fear to the Corellian-run scoundrels and Carita Corsairs. Even the Nova Blades have taken notice of you. My master would be most impressed.
I should like to confer with your master. You will arrange an introduction.
It just so happens that my master would like very much to see you, and has authorized me to direct you to a point of contact. Oh, do be careful in your travels. Legend or no, Goro's brother Grom is severely displeased as to Goro's fate.
Abduskela, Biorore! Talk now. Primslim Monita, Rikokashuroreg.
I'd let the meaning of that fact sink in a second before you act.
Furomero, Tartalne Soeva Rumsek. Eiling, Onredonatsa, Tingnobum Fry, Ramirukshak. Look now, Grim Slim Monita, Rikoka Shuro Reg.
Grim, Javitsa! Gola, Gola, Team Unstable Drar!
Unsona, no Murdakin Pavubi Freya. Wine Nikro, Krorubark.
There. It's finished. Lana Benito.
Dark Lord, an honor as ever. And how fares the Dark Council?
Forget about the Dark Council. I'd much rather discuss how you've been since we last met.
I see you haven't changed. Good.
Not interrupting anything, am I? Just kidding, I don't really care.
Hello, Theron.
Is that a good hello or a bad one? Outside of Lana, I can never tell with you Imperial types.
Be grateful I'm working with you, and leave it at that.
So definitely a good hello. Got it.
If we're to succeed here, we'll need to cooperate a great deal. I suggest we don't antagonize one another.
Yeah, okay. Well, in the spirit of cooperation, I'll get things rolling. The Revanites are here, on Rishi. That's why we led you here under false pretenses. They can't know we're onto them. We need you to go out there and make life hard for the Revanites' allies, the Nova Blades.
I know the Nova Blades are running things in Raiders Cove, but how are they helping the Revanites?
From what we've been able to gather, the Revanites agents in the Empire and Republic have been feeding the Nova Blades intel on ship activity. The Blades then use that intel to ambush military patrols and key shipping lanes on both sides. They're essentially remapping hyper routes.
We should be taking the fight to the Order of Revan directly.
If we knew where on this planet they were situated, we would do just that.
Hate to admit it, but I haven't been able to remotely slice the Blades' computers. I have to have their security shut down.
The trouble is, we can't have any suspicion raised that our attack is related to the Revanites' activities.
So I am meant to be some base pirate who has a beef with the Nova Blades?
Yeah, you've got it exactly. Bust up their operations, get their attention, make yourself look legitimate, and then go for the throat.
We have a trusted source who's determined that the Nova Blades base, a wrecked ship called the Aggressor, contains their entire security apparatus. That's our final target.
Where do I start?
That's the spirit. We'll place you in range of the first Nova Blade target. That's where our source is waiting.
It really is good to see you again.
Been hiding out a long time. It's nice to see someone who isn't a complete stranger. Good luck out there.
Yes. May the Force serve you well.
It's you! It's really you! I can hardly believe my optical circuits.
Jakaro, I don't think I can take any more flapping out of that synthesized yap.
All bluster aside, this planet's inhabitants are not to be trifled with. The Nova Blades in particular are a powerful and organized group. That is why we intend to depower and disorganize them by firing from Jakaro's ship on the targets of your choosing.
They see me causing trouble, and word gets out that the Howling Tempest Gang is coming for the Nova Blades.
Precisely! It's nice to not have to explain everything for a change. I'd wish you good luck if I thought you'd need it. We'll keep in touch.
It's like a war zone, Commodore. We're gonna lose everything if we don't airlift what's left to the slave camp.
And we're not backing down just because some upstart crew thinks they got what it takes to break us. Buckle down, be a Nova Blade, and kill whoever's messing with us.
But Commodore Margok...
Go tell your Commodore and anyone else who'll listen that the Howling Tempest Gang is taking over Raiders Cove.
Heard stories about you. Drop Goro. Put a fright into that weasel Zykin. I took down a dozen contenders to get this post. I ain't even a little bit scared of you.
I was hoping you'd pick that one.
The job's done.
Excellent news, but it's only our first step.
One of the Nova Blades mentioned a slave camp, somewhere remote. We should strike there next.
Good call, actually. I ran across some chatter about that place. Basically, anyone in Raiders Cove who doesn't give the Nova Blades a slice of their action or whatever gets locked away. Some get put into hazardous labor, like mining, but most are sold as slaves to visitors from off-world. It's a lucrative business for the Blades.
Not anymore.
You got that right. You'll have to slip in with one of the Nova Blades' cargo shipments. I'm sure the island's heavily guarded, so try not to get killed.
I believe Theron means to say he's concerned for your safety, as am I. May the Force serve you well.
Jakaro, I have a pickup for you.
C2D4 here. We have your coordinates and are on our way. Been mining Exonium for the Blades every day for 2 years. All to pay off a lousy $3,000 I owed. And I ain't the only one.
Your debt's the least of the Nova Blades' worries right now.
I believe it. Even in this place, we hear stuff. About your gang, the way you've been making life ugly for the Blades. We want to be a part of that.
You want to work for me?
Hey, we're good at a whole lot of stuff. Tell you what, get in touch with a pal of mine in Raiders Cove, Harlow Ricks. Check in with Ricks from time to time, tell him what you want us to do, and we'll do it. Simple as that. You get nice and close to Margok. You give him one for me, all right?
I'd say the Nova Blades are properly distracted, wouldn't you?
That would be an understatement. Theron's been monitoring communications. You've caused quite a stir.
Want some gratification? Here, check this out. Just recorded.
They're blasting up my supplies, my foot soldiers, taking my workers. What are you people prepared to do about it?
This appears to be your problem, not ours.
How would you like it if I made it your personal problem? Give me Revan! I want to talk to Revan!
No, I don't think so.
You don't put Revan on. The Nova Blades stop rerouting galactic traffic. That ain't negotiable.
Revan.
Commodore Margok, are you threatening to alter the terms of our deal? I paid you to do a job and you've done it well. But that's over now. I no longer have any use for your Nova Blades.
Hey, I know Torch and her Mandalorian clan up and left us, but the Blades still got a lot to offer.
Not if you don't have your own house in order. Put an end to the upstart causing you trouble, and I'll consider resuming our alliance.
You really did it. You got them running scared.
Naturally. You were expecting some other outcome?
Guess it was silly of me to question, huh?
The Nova Blades still have an impressive roster of hardened criminals at their disposal, and the aggressor is still heavily fortified.
The aggressor's their headquarters. You've seen it. A crashed ship Margok turned into a fortress. Can't get in without the proper security codes.
That won't be a problem for me.
We'll get Jakaro to lend a hand all the same.
If nothing else, the activity will keep him from picking apart D4 any further.
Theron.
Finally in. Nice work. Now to see where Margok's hiding all his secrets.
You. You dirty, no-good pirate scum.
This is it, Margok. The Nova Blades are finished, and so are you.
My forebears founded Raiders Cove. This is my island, and I'm not giving it up. So come on in. Do your worst. In the end, you ain't coming out alive.
They've got live slicers and they're managing network security on the fly. I can't do anything until they're offline.
I'll handle it.
I'm sure you will.
This is my ship. Think you could just walk on in and be left alive?
Theron, are you getting this?
Loud and clear. I'm in. Full access.
This is the sort of momentum we could never create on our own. We need to maintain that momentum. Surely, if the Revanites are done with the Nova Blades, as Revan indicated, they're onto the next stage of their plan.
There'd better be something in the Nova Blades files that sheds some light on what Revan's doing with those hyperspace routes.
Yeah, tell me about it. Starting to feel like flying blind is the new normal.
While Theron's pulling down data, I suggest you start to make your way back to Raiders Cove. Hopefully he'll have found something of use by then.
What have we learned from the aggressor?
Very little, I'm afraid. It would appear someone took it upon themselves to corrupt much of the data as a last resort.
It's a real mess, getting fragments but nothing incredibly coherent. The one thing that does keep turning up is the Mandalorian Margok brought up earlier, the one they call Torch.
What about her?
Well, it looks like Torch and Margok were thick as thieves for a while, then something happened. Had to do with the Revanites. Don't really know the details, but it looks like Torch moved her whole clan to another island here on Rishi. I've got the coordinates.
Jakaro, ready your ship. I'll go see what this Torch has to say for herself.
I'm sending Jakaro out on a scouting run. I've made local arrangements for your transportation should he not return in time.
Well, you've been busier than I thought.
Get whatever information you can from the Mandalorians. With any luck, they'll lead us to the Revanites.
Dark Lord, Moff Pyron ready to report.
What do you have for me, Pyron?
Your apprentice Ashara briefed me on the Order of Revan. We are discreetly sweeping for infiltrators in your ranks.
Good.
If I may, I've also prepared a briefing on current military operations. I'll endeavor to be quick. As for the Cylindan campaign, Darth Maar is coordinating the joint armada with minimal losses. That does raise the issue, however. Our silencer fleet killers are underperforming as the Republic adapts tactically and technologically. We may be able to refine the silencer cannons further, but their radiation output will begin to kill our own gunners. Shall we proceed?
Make the refinements, but post a skeleton crew to any ships so equipped. We have only so many troops to spare.
Yes, Dark Lord. There is also the question of Alzar. Darth Ravage still believes the natives hold no value and expands rapidly into their territory. Your overseers on Korriban believe the Alzarians might be trained as Sith, but to recruit them now could make an enemy of Ravage.
Let Ravage whine at the next council meeting. The Empire needs allies, not resentful colonies.
As you wish. One last order of business. I understand you're on Rishi. Normally, I wouldn't bother you with trivialities, but...
Speak, Pyron.
You have a servant there by the name of Lord Vigil. Like many, he's been seeking an audience since your ascension. He won't say why, or speak to anyone but you. However, Thanaton clearly prized him. He received significant resources for his research.
Do we know anything about what he's doing on Rishi?
Vigil was designated a seeker into matters exotic and arcane. Quite a few of your researchers have this designation. Whether Vigil's work is productive or, like certain other legacy projects, mere eccentricity, is not for me to judge.
Where do I find him?
I'll send coordinates. Perhaps your archaeologist might assess Vigil's work with some insight as well.
Then you are dismissed.
My life for yours, Dark Lord.
I recall Vigil's name, but we've never met. What do you suppose he's found out here?
Darth Nox, everlasting Night Lord. It is my deepest honor to welcome you to Rishi. I'd begun to doubt... I was a fool.
You sought an audience, and I have come. The Reclamation Service will observe.
On my life, I shall not disappoint. I was sent here 30 years ago, not for Rishi, but to stand on the brink of the Rishi Maze, the dwarf galaxy. Thousands of unexplored worlds just beyond the known hyperlanes. My master tasked me to monitor those dark stars.
You seek knowledge in the unknown reaches of space. Fair enough. What have you found?
I built A deep space communications array to watch, to listen, to try to contact the maze's inhabitants. And I received signals, messages. The language is ancient, contemptuous of translation. There are Sith words, Rakata, Gri. The messages contained instructions for improving, modifying the communications array. Even I don't understand what functions the machines now possess.
These modifications, the technology, did the signals hint what they might be for?
Only in that the technology would grant a great boon. I couldn't discern more than that.
Alien machine enhancements. Now we know where the Reclamation Service budget went.
The signals went silent some years ago, but I believe the array is now waiting for you.
Waiting for me?
The last messages said the array required one twice transmuted and reborn to the mother.
Transmuted, as I was on Balmora, and by the corruption of the Sith spirits.
And then rejuvenated by the mother machine of Belsarvis. Fascinating.
Some distant species has been waiting for you, Dark Lord, whether by prophecy or biology. You could activate the array. Learn its purpose.
By fate or happenstance, we're here now. I won't turn away from a mystery. I'll examine your machines. Await my return.
Yes, Dark Lord. Yes.
As they say in the service, the prudent learn, the bold are enlightened.
Lord Vajil.
Was all to your satisfaction, my lord? Were the machines responsive?
The Dark Lord's lifespan increases by a solar cycle. Does that mean something to you?
Then, it was real.
What was real?
Real! Arctis believed, Thanaton believed, but I doubted. I feared to offer you false hope. The machines are made to increase life expectancy, cellular rejuvenation. For anyone without your exotic past, the process would surely have failed. But for you, Dark Lord, those machines have granted you months or years, a taste of immortality.
A taste of immortality. I've awaited this opportunity. But I desire more than a few extra dying breaths in my twilight years.
Oh, of course, of course. Then grant me the means to fulfill your wish. Grant me battalions to pacify this world. Grant me scientists to replicate the machines. Grant me fleets to explore the dwarf galaxy. Now we know. The secret to your everlasting glory is here. We need only find it.
My lord, I have concerns about this course of action.
You are here to advise. Advise me.
The long search for immortality so often leads to ruin. You saw this with your first master. Who will count Zash among the great Sith when she squandered her power on a fruitless quest? And now, with our Empire in such need of your resources...
I will remember your counsel, but I am not Zash. Lord Vajil, Moff Pyron will supply you troops as soon as possible. Keep me informed of all progress.
Yes, Dark Lord. If it requires a year and 1,000 men for each month of life you gain, it will be done.
Good. For now, I have an Empire to run and crises to see to.
All glory to Darth Nox.
All glory to you.
Approaching Torches Island.
Thank you.
I take it you're the one they call Torch.
Shea Visla. That little nickname the locals came up with. Hell if I know why.
You recently had a falling out with the Revanites and the Nova Blades. Tell me everything.
Oh, tell you everything. Sure, of course. Because I never had a Sith try to assert themselves before. Tell you what. Instead of whatever grand gesture of cooperation you thought might happen here, why don't we try something a little different? Been a while since I had a decent challenge. I'm taking this opportunity to show my clan how it's done.
Son of a...
Okay, so I'm a little rustier than I'd like to admit. But just a little. Felt good to be in a real scrap for once.
You got what you wanted. Time to return the favor.
Well, that would be fair, wouldn't it? So, you know the Blades went and partnered up with the Revanites. Means you probably know they're up to no good. We helped out the Blades to have a good relationship with Raiders Cove. We didn't sign up for the Revanites and their all-out war, so we bailed.
Tell me where the Revanites are, and what I'm up against.
Afraid I don't have the where to give you. But I can clue you in on the what. A whole fleet of ships they've got parked somewhere around here. I wouldn't mind it a bit if you chased the Revanites out of Rishi. Off the radar is just how we like it here. Good hunting to you, Sith. Kesush Mandoade! Who's up for a Skarkla hunt?
Understand your frustration, Jakaro, but there's only so much of your bluster I'm prepared to take.
What's going on?
Theron's been captured by the Revanites. Data from the Nova Blades hinted at the location of a Revanite safe house in Raiders Cove. We looked into it and were ambushed.
Revan knew we were here.
It looks that way. It's possible he may have sensed our presence. I couldn't say for sure. Whatever the case, I stand by my decision to not impede in Theron's abduction. And I know Theron would too. Now he's in a position to do what he does.
We're talking about a seasoned SIS operative. If the Revanites took him to their base, he could learn a lot.
Of course, if we're to make any use of that knowledge, we'll have to exfiltrate him all the same. Hopefully you fared better with the Mandalorians.
Revan has a fleet of warships on standby.
Of course. From examining the Nova Blade's data, it looks as though they've been routing Imperial and Republic fleets here to Rishi.
So the Empire and the Republic are drawn into a full-scale battle, and whoever's left standing, the Revanites pick off.
And we still don't know who we can trust. We need to interfere with the Revanites' plans, if not stop them outright.
Yes, it's true. I was able to pinpoint several communications originating from another island. I'm told there's a Rishi village on the outskirts. I can't imagine they would resent our presence there.
Then we will go there immediately and establish a base of operations for my campaign. In the end, Revan will answer to me.
Yes, my lord. We have to assume Revan's expecting a resistance force now. You should expect to find patrols along the way.
You're new.
Are you in charge here?
We don't really operate that way, but I can act as that sort of figure if you require it of me. How might I help?
My allies and I would like to stay here.
Do what you like. No Rishi will have an issue with your presence.
I suppose now that we've left Raiders Cove, you're going to start complaining about them instead of the pirates.
You cleared the path well.
and made a friend.
I am called Arenkau.
The other inhabitants on this island, are you in contact with them? Do you know what they're up to?
If an individual Rishi chooses to get involved with others, that's that Rishi's choice. Otherwise, we tend to see no reason to inquire. These other inhabitants, they have also kept to themselves. Strangely, their encampment appears to be segregated. One group looks like her, the other is less intense.
If they have more of you in their roster, I might be joining the Revanites. You flatter me.
If their Sith Lords are anywhere near as deadly as Lana, we're in deeper trouble than when we almost became fish food on Manan.
So there's a camp for Imperial traitors and one for Republic Revanites. And they're not exactly friends. This may provide an opportunity, either to extract atonement for their deception or to employ a little deception of our own.
It's an opportunity to thin the ranks, is what it is.
Your zeal for making heads roll never ceases to surprise me, D4. But don't worry yourself, it may yet come to that.
I'll take a closer look at these Revanite camps.
And we'll attempt to establish a better grasp of their activities.
I hope we can establish where Agent Shan is being held.
As do I.
We, Rishi, would be grateful for your help around the village. If you choose to provide it, of course. Savor your travels.
Be patient, Sergeant, but be ready. As soon as we have word from Revan, our work begins.
Lord Ivris, sir, there's... It's...
Dark Lord, how can this be? We're found out. I suppose Darth Maar sent you to fight his battle for him. Seems his usual way. No, better still. You learned about us and thought Maar could be in on it. You're here on your own. We have the upper hand.
When the Empire and the Republic come after you, do you really think it will end with the Revanites on top?
I fight for that in which I believe. Should I perish in service to Revan's goals, so be it.
You used to fight for something else you believed in. At least with the Empire, you stood a chance of having your efforts matter.
She makes an excellent point, my lord.
It does seem we've been less than a step ahead for some time now. Opposition at our heels and in the shadows. You'll get no further resistance from me. I can't vouch for every last Imperial Revanite, of course, but I can speak for those present.
What do you intend to do about the others?
Captain Millinex Republic contingent? Whatever your move, you'll have my fighters at your back. Ultimately, we are loyal to the Empire.
There have been reports of skirmishes in the area. I want you to stay alert for anything out of the ordinary.
Such as?
By the stars! Be ready to fire on my mark!
No, not on your mark. On mine.
You've got Ivers' people. You've turned him against the cause. Whatever you think you've accomplished, you won't stop Revan, I promise you.
You can barely hold your composure. I know you fear me.
I don't know where Revan is. Not for sure. But there's a stronghold. In the valley. It's where they took Thurin Shan. I swear, it's the best information I have. And I can't ask up the chain, they'll only grow suspicious of me.
You have far outlived your usefulness, Captain. If ever you were useful to begin with. Lana, Theron's being held in a valley stronghold. Could be Revan is there as well.
I'll have D4 see what the Rishi know about it. We'll work out a plan of attack once you've returned.
I've never met a people quite like the Rishi. Pragmatic, accommodating, reasonable. If it wasn't for the climate, I'd consider staying.
I haven't had any problems with them so far.
Always be at least a little guarded. Not the worst way to live, considering all the betrayal on display. As I mentioned earlier, I did acquire some information worth noting. Rishi observations surrounding the Revanite stronghold fit what we know. They're holding powerful warships on standby, and they're well protected.
Revan actually intends to take on the Imperial and Republic fleets all at once.
It's audacious, to be sure. We've been unable to reach the Imperial fleet nearing Rishi, but I can confirm from the Nova Blade's data logs that Darth Maar's flagship is among them.
Get to work on a solution for our connection issues. He needs to know what's coming.
I'm working to remap the interference patterns into a code that protocol droids on approaching ships should be able to decipher, if they're any good.
Press on. Stall their ships if you can, and we'll do what we can from here to reach the fleet and lend support as needed.
I'm no pushover, but you aren't joking. We do hope Agent Shan is recovered.
Yes. Preferably alive. Now go show the Revanites, and, fate willing, Revan himself, why you are not to be trifled with.
I'm starting to get the hang of slicing. Theron's influence, I suppose. Give me one second. There. A holo record of Theron under interrogation. Coordinates are coming your way.
And Revan?
No indication he's there, but no indication he isn't either. I wouldn't let my guard down.
Revan.
I should have known the Empire would send one of its lapdogs to try and find me. You should never have bothered.
What have you done with Theron?
Theron Shan's fate doesn't matter. Neither does yours. I'm changing the fate of the galaxy itself.
All I see is you trying to destroy everything.
I'm not waging some war with the Empire and Republic. I'm saving countless lives, and you keep getting in the way. The only upside in your being here, really, is that you get to bear witness. My plan's too far along for you to stop it now.
Don't listen to him. It's not over yet.
Theron, there you are.
Figured I had a lot to tell you, so I broke out. Guess I could have saved myself the trouble. Don't know how much Lana or Revan told you, but he's lured the Imperial and Republic command fleets to Rishi.
Revan wants to draw them into a fight. Try to take out the leadership.
It'll barely be a fight. Revanites embedded on both sides are gonna sabotage shields, weapons, you name it. And we can't warn them. Revan had the Nova Blades build him a signal jammer. No communications at all up in Rishi space. It'll be a bloodbath.
One call to Jakaro and no more signal jammer.
The Revanites got that thing protected. You send Jakaro out there and he and D4 become part of the landscape. This place is coming down. Soon.
You could have joined me, Theron. Understandably, you're as tenacious as I ever was. Goodbye.
Hello? Are you there?
Lana, what just happened?
I appear to have sliced through four layers of encryption to remotely deactivate the power core.
Just in the nick of time. Don't know if I could have managed that even.
Theron, good to know you're alive. I heard everything, about the jammer, all of it. We need to regroup for an immediate attack. Whatever happens, be proud of what we've accomplished up to now. See you soon.
All right. Take it easy, I'm not exactly 100%, and you're not exactly gentle.
Oh, good! The team's back together again. All thanks to you for saving Theron, of course.
He's lucky I arrived when I did.
I'd hardly say this. You know what, never mind.
Theron, you have the intelligence on this signal jammer. You start.
Right. The intelligence I gathered in the company of several interrogation probes while being held against my will? Jammer's on a nearby island. You've probably seen it. Can't be sliced remotely. Lots of Revanite zealots protecting it. The usual hopeless nightmare, basically.
Let them try to stop me.
Time's running short. You know what to do. It's what you always do. Triumph.
I don't know if you can read me, but I've arrived.
We read you.
Come in. Can anyone read me?
I'm here. And you are on Rishi.
Darth Maar, you have traitors in your fleet. Scores of them, acting under orders from Revan.
Revan is alive?
He wants you to destroy each other up there.
Have the fleet power down all weapons. Do it now.
Your people should have a list of the traitors. Finally, an open line.
Grandmaster Sean, it appears we have been set upon each other by your ancestor.
Yes, we were notified by an agent of ours whose planet side. We're taking measures to detain the traitors among us.
As are we. Given the nature of the threat, I suggest we speak in person.
Very well. A neutral location.
There's a pirate town on Rishi. My team will send the coordinates.
That will do. Then we are agreed. A truce. For the time being.
It would appear we've reached an accord. And without a council majority.
We both know time is too short for consultations and politics.
Satil Shan, Grand Master of the Jedi Order. Your intervention allowed us to defend ourselves against the Revanite fleet. Many thousands owe their lives to your actions.
And the all-encompassing rot of the Order of Revan has been excised from our fleets. Now we turn to the matter of Revan himself.
My agent here has discovered that Revan's on the fourth moon of Yavin, where he believes the last spark of the Sith Emperor resides.
Revan intends to return the Emperor from the brink of death, so he may finally be destroyed.
I take no issue with the Emperor's demise. He no longer holds any power over us.
Agreed, but there's more to it than that. The Emperor hungers. If restored, he would attempt to consume all life in the galaxy, and I am certain he would succeed. No one, not Revan, not the Jedi, not you, not me, would be able to stop him.
Darth Maar and I will be leading a joint strike force on Yavin 4 to put an end to Revan's plan. I hope you'll join us.
As do I. For the Empire and for the galaxy.
That went surprisingly well, I think.
Yeah. It's nice to see the Empire and Republican work together without stabbing each other in the back.
It was the right move, arranging for your capture. We've succeeded, haven't we?
Unbelievable. Where's the trust, huh? Did they go wander off someplace, or was it never there to start with?
If you were in on the plan, the Revanites might have been able to see that.
What, you mean mind tricks and all that? I have implants. I'm protected.
I meant your performance. Admit it, you might have betrayed the truth.
It's not impossible, okay? Let's just drop it. Isn't there anything else you wanted first?
Yes. Will that be all?
Theron, help Jakaro ready his ship for departure. Lana and I have unfinished business.
Don't have to tell me twice. Come on, Jakaro.
Some truths, they linger more than others. Like how friendship isn't easy to come by. How trust is far more rare. Theron trusted me, and I don't think he ever will again.
Theron Shan is a Republic agent. He is not your friend.
I've tried not to think about it, but I know you're right. When all this is over, if we survive, we'll be back to working at cross purposes. I know there's no other way. It's like when we first met. I knew our fates were going to be intertwined completely. I've tried to maintain my poise, deny my senses. But I can't. Not anymore.
You don't have to.
It's true what they say. Patience is its own reward.
We should go now.
Yes, absolutely. I'll make sure Theron and Jakaro are ready to head to Yavin 4. Every moment wasted is a moment in Revan's favor.
C2-D4 here. We have your coordinates and are on our way.
Been mining Exonium for the Blades every day for 2 years. All to pay off a lousy $3,000 I owed. And I ain't the only one.
Your debt's the least of the Nova Blades' worries right now.
I believe it. Even in this place, we hear stuff. About your gang, the way you've been making life ugly for the Blades. We want to be a part of that.
You want to work for me?
Hey, we're good at a whole lot of stuff. Tell you what, get in touch with a pal of mine in Raiders Cove. Harlow Ricks. Check in with Ricks from time to time, tell him what you want us to do, and we'll do it. Simple as that. You get nice and close to Margok. You give him one for me, all right?
Say the Nova Blades are properly distracted, wouldn't you?
That would be an understatement. Theron's been monitoring communications. You've caused quite a stir.
Want some gratification? Here, check this out. Just recorded.
You're blasting up my supplies, my foot soldiers, taking my workers. What are you people prepared to do about it?
This appears to be your problem, not ours.
How would you like it if I made it your personal problem? Give me Revan! I want to talk to Revan!
No, I don't think so.
You don't put Revan on. The Nova Blades stop rerouting galactic traffic. That ain't negotiable.
Revan.
Commodore Margok, are you threatening to alter the terms of our deal? I paid you to do a job and you've done it well. But that's over now. I no longer have any use for your Nova Blades.
Hey, I know Torch and her Mandalorian clan up and left us, but the Blades still got a lot to offer.
Not if you don't have your own house in order. Put an end to the upstart causing you trouble, and I'll consider resuming our alliance.
You really did it. You got them running scared.
Naturally. You were expecting some other outcome?
Guess it was silly of me to question, huh?
The Nova Blades still have an impressive roster of hardened criminals at their disposal, and the Aggressor is still heavily fortified.
The Aggressor's their headquarters. You've seen it. A crashed ship Margok turned into a fortress. Can't get in without the proper security codes.
That won't be a problem for me.
We'll get Jacaro to lend a hand all the same.
If nothing else, the activity will keep him from picking apart D4 any further.
Saren.
Finally in. Nice work. Now to see where Margok's hiding all his secrets.
You. You dirty, no-good pirate scum.
This is it, Margok. The Nova Blades are finished, and so are you.
My forebears founded Raiders Cove. This is my island, and I'm not giving it up. So come on in. Do your worst. In the end, you ain't coming out alive.
They've got live slicers and they're managing network security on the fly. I can't do anything until they're offline.
I'll handle it.
I'm sure you will.
This is my ship. Think you could just walk on in and be left alive?
Theron, are you getting this?
Loud and clear. I'm in. Full access.
This is the sort of momentum we could never create on our own. We need to maintain that momentum. Surely, if the Revanites are done with the Nova Blades, as Revan indicated, they're onto the next stage of their plan.
There'd better be something in the Nova Blades files that sheds some light on what Revan's doing with those hyperspace routes.
Yeah, tell me about it. Starting to feel like flying blind is the new normal.
While Theron's pulling down data, I suggest you start to make your way back to Raiders Cove. Hopefully he'll have found something of use by then.
What have we learned from the Aggressor?
Very little, I'm afraid. It would appear someone took it upon themselves to corrupt much of the data as a last resort.
It's a real mess, getting fragments but nothing incredibly coherent. The one thing that does keep turning up is the Mandalorian Margok brought up earlier, the one they call Torch.
What about her?
Well, it looks like Torch and Margok were thick as thieves for a while, then something happened. Had to do with the Revanites. Don't really know the details, but it looks like Torch moved her whole clan to another island here on Rishi. I've got the coordinates.
Jacaro, ready your ship. I'll go see what this Torch has to say for herself.
I'm sending Jacaro out on a scouting run. I've made local arrangements for your transportation should he not return in time.
Well, you've been busier than I thought.
Get whatever information you can from the Mandalorians. With any luck, they'll lead us to the Revanites.
Dark Lord. Moff Pyron, ready to report.
What do you have for me, Pyron?
Your apprentice Ashara briefed me on the Order of Revan. We are discreetly sweeping for infiltrators in your ranks.
Good.
If I may, I've also prepared a briefing on current military operations. I'll endeavor to be quick. As for the Cylindan campaign, Darth Maar is coordinating the joint armada with minimal losses. That does raise the issue, however. Our silencer fleet killers are underperforming as the Republic adapts tactically and technologically. We may be able to refine the silencer cannons further, but their radiation output will begin to kill our own gunners. Shall we proceed?
Make the refinements, but post a skeleton crew to any ship so equipped. We have only so many troops to spare.
Yes, Dark Lord. There is also the question of Alzar. Darth Ravage still believes the natives hold no value and expands rapidly into their territory. Your overseers on Korriban believe the Alzarians might be trained as Sith, but to recruit them now could make an enemy of Ravage.
Let Ravage whine at the next council meeting. The Empire needs allies, not resentful colonies.
As you wish. One last order of business. I understand you're on Rishi. Normally, I wouldn't bother you with trivialities, but...
Speak, Pyron.
You have a servant there by the name of Lord Vigil. Like many, he's been seeking an audience since your ascension. He won't say why, or speak to anyone but you. However, Thanaton clearly prized him. He received significant resources for his research.
Do we know anything about what he's doing on Rishi?
Vigil was designated a seeker into matters exotic and arcane. Quite a few of your researchers have this designation. Whether Vigil's work is productive or, like certain other legacy projects, mere eccentricity, is not for me to judge.
Where do I find him?
I'll send coordinates. Perhaps your archaeologist might assess Vigil's work with some insight as well.
Then you are dismissed.
My life for yours, Dark Lord.
I recall Vigil's name, but we've never met. What do you suppose he's found out here?
Darth Nox, everlasting Night Lord. It is my deepest honor to welcome you to Rishi. I'd begun to doubt... I was a fool.
You sought an audience, and I have come. The Reclamation Service will observe.
On my life, I shall not disappoint. I was sent here 30 years ago, not for Rishi, but to stand on the brink of the Rishi Maze, the dwarf galaxy. Thousands of unexplored worlds just beyond the known hyperlanes. My master tasked me to monitor those dark stars.
You seek knowledge in the unknown reaches of space. Fair enough. What have you found?
I built a deep space communications array to watch, to listen, to...
Yes! Thank you, Temuda! I knew there was a reason I kept you around. Here, you could find and unlock the case with this tracer, and you could even keep the datapad. How's that?
I'll take your datapad. But that doesn't mean I'm done with you.
Gotta hand it to you. The Whirling Tempest crew don't mess around. Right. That's what I said.
Kaizaikun. Greetings. I speak to you now to deliver a warning. The Howling Tempest Gang is one of the galaxy's most feared pirate associations. They have just now set their sights on Rishi. As you know, the Corellian-run scoundrels owe the Howling Tempest Gang a great many credits. There is no telling what will happen when you are discovered. I suggest you herald the gang's arrival to draw unwanted attention on them. I'm dispatching several droids across Raiders Cove to do the same. Or you could do nothing and suffer the consequences. The choice is yours.
Greetings to you! Would you like to hear a true story about the legendary Howling Tempest Gang? Oh, I beg your pardon! I didn't realize it was you! How exciting! Such a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
You should consider yourself honored and fortunate to have this opportunity.
Indeed I do! My master did not prepare me for the sheer measure of awe I would be required to process. Why, in the time since your arrival, you have already defeated the illustrious Goro, brought fear to the Corellian-run scoundrels and Carita Corsairs. Even the Nova Blades have taken notice of you. My master would be most impressed.
I should like to confer with your master. You will arrange an introduction.
It just so happens that my master would like very much to see you, and has authorized me to direct you to a point of contact. Oh, do be careful in your travels. legend or no, Goro's brother Grom is severely displeased as to Goro's fate.
Aptuskela, Biorore! Talk now. Primslimonita, Rikokashuroreg.
I'd let the meaning of that fact sink in a second before you act.
Furomero, Tartalne soeva rumsek. Ailing, Onredonatsa, Tinnobum fry, Ramirukshak. Look now, Grim Slimmonita, Rikokashuroreg.
Grim, Javitsa! Gola, Gola, Timon Stabledrar!
Unsona, Nomordakin Pavubi Freya. Wine Nikro, Krorubark.
There. It's finished. Lana Benito.
Dark Lord, an honor as ever. And how fares the Dark Council?
Forget about the Dark Council. I'd much rather discuss how you've been since we last met.
I see you haven't changed. Good.
Not interrupting anything, am I? Just kidding, I don't really care.
Hello, Theron.
Is that a good hello or a bad one? Outside of Lana, I can never tell with you Imperial types.
Be grateful I'm working with you, and leave it at that.
So definitely a good hello. Got it.
If we're to succeed here, we'll need to cooperate a great deal. I suggest we don't antagonize one another.
Yeah, okay. Well, in the spirit of cooperation, I'll get things rolling. The Revanites are here, on Rishi. That's why we led you here under false pretenses. They can't know we're onto them. We need you to go out there and make life hard for the Revanites' allies, the Nova Blades.
I know the Nova Blades are running things in Raiders Cove, but how are they helping the Revanites?
From what we've been able to gather, the Revanites' agents in the Empire and Republic have been feeding the Nova Blades intel on ship activity. The Blades then use that intel to ambush military patrols and key shipping lanes on both sides. They're essentially remapping hyperroutes.
We should be taking the fight to the Order of Revan directly.
If we knew where on this planet they were situated, we would do just that.
Hate to admit it, but I haven't been able to remotely slice the Blade's computers. I have to have their security shut down.
The trouble is, we can't have any suspicion raised that our attack is related to the Revanites' activities.
So I am meant to be some base pirate who has a beef with the Nova Blades?
Yeah, you've got it exactly. Bust up their operations, get their attention, make yourself look legitimate, and then go for the throat.
We have a trusted source who's determined that the Nova Blades base, a wrecked ship called the Aggressor, contains their entire security apparatus. That's our final target.
Where do I start?
That's the spirit. We'll place you in range of the first Nova Blade target. That's where our source is waiting.
It really is good to see you again.
Been hiding out a long time. It's nice to see someone who isn't a complete stranger. Good luck out there.
Yes. May the Force serve you well.
It's you! It's really you! I can hardly believe my optical circuits.
Jakaro, I don't think I can take any more flapping out of that synthesized yap.
All bluster aside, this planet's inhabitants are not to be trifled with. The Nova Blades in particular are a powerful and organized group. That is why we intend to depower and disorganize them by firing from Jakaro's ship on the targets of your choosing.
They see me causing trouble, and word gets out that the Howling Tempest Gang is coming for the Nova Blades.
Precisely! It's nice to not have to explain everything for a change. I'd wish you good luck if I thought you'd need it. We'll keep in touch.
It's like a war zone, Commodore. We're gonna lose everything if we don't airlift what's left to the slave camp.
And we're not backing down just because some upstart crew thinks they got what it takes to break us. Buckle down, be a Nova Blade, and kill whoever's messing with us.
But Commodore Margok...
Go tell your Commodore and anyone else who'll listen that the Howling Tempest Gang is taking over Raiders Cove.
Heard stories about you. Dropped Goro. Put a fright into that weasel Zykin. I took down a dozen contenders to get this post. I ain't even a little bit scared of you.
I was hoping you'd pick that one.
The job's done.
Excellent news, but it's only our first step.
One of the Nova Blades mentioned a slave camp, somewhere remote. We should strike there next.
Good call, actually. I ran across some chatter about that place. Basically, anyone in Raiders Cove who doesn't give the Nova Blades a slice of their action or whatever gets locked away. Some get put into hazardous labor, like mining, but most are sold as slaves to visitors from off-world. It's a lucrative business for the Blades.
Not anymore.
You got that right. You'll have to slip in with one of the Nova Blade's cargo shipments. I'm sure the island's heavily guarded, so try not to get killed.
I believe Theron means to say he's concerned for your safety, as am I. May the Force serve you well.
Jakaro, I have a pickup for you.
Try to contact the maze's inhabitants. And I received signals, messages. The language is ancient, contemptuous of translation. There are Sith words, Rakata, Gri. The messages contained instructions for improving, modifying the communications array. Even I don't understand what functions the machines now possess.
These modifications, the technology, did the signals hint what they might be for?
Only in that the technology would grant a great boon. I couldn't discern more than that.
Alien machine enhancements. Now we know where the Reclamation Service budget went.
The signals went silent some years ago, but I believe the array is now waiting for you.
Waiting for me?
The last messages said the array required one twice transmuted and reborn to the mother.
Transmuted, as I was on Balmora, and by the corruption of the Sith spirits.
And then rejuvenated by the mother machine of Belsarvis. Fascinating.
Some distant species has been waiting for you, Dark Lord, whether by prophecy or biology. You could activate the array. Learn its purpose.
By fate or happenstance, we're here now. I won't turn away from a mystery. I'll examine your machines. Await my return.
Yes, Dark Lord. Yes.
As they say in the service, the prudent learn, the bold are enlightened.
Lord Vajil.
Was all to your satisfaction, my lord? Were the machines responsive?
The Dark Lord's lifespan increases by a solar cycle. Does that mean something to you?
Then, it was real.
What was real?
Real, Arctis believed, Thanaton believed, but I doubted. I feared to offer you false hope. The machines are made to increase life expectancy, cellular rejuvenation. For anyone without your exotic past, the process would surely have failed. But for you, Dark Lord, those machines have granted you months or years, a taste of immortality.
A taste of immortality. I've awaited this opportunity. But I desire more than a few extra dying breaths in my twilight years.
Oh, of course, of course. Then grant me the means to fulfill your wish. Grant me battalions to pacify this world. Grant me scientists to replicate the machines. Grant me fleets to explore the dwarf galaxy. Now we know the secret to your everlasting glory is here. We need only find it.
My lord, I have concerns about this course of action.
You are here to advise. Advise me.
The long search for immortality so often leads to ruin. You saw this with your first master. Who will count Zash among the great Sith when she squandered her power on a fruitless quest? And now, with our empire in such need of your resources...
I will remember your counsel. But I am not Zash. Lord Vajal, Moff Pyron will supply you troops as soon as possible. Keep me informed of all progress.
Yes, Dark Lord. If it requires a year and 1,000 men for each month of life you gain, it will be done.
Good. For now, I have an empire to run and crises to see to.
All glory to Darth Nox.
All glory to you.
Approaching Torches Island. Take it you're the one they call Torch.
Shay Visla. That little nickname the locals came up with. Hell if I know why.
You recently had a falling out with the Revanites and the Nova Blades. Tell me everything.
Oh, tell you everything. Sure, of course. Because I never had a Sith try to assert themselves before. Tell you what. Instead of whatever grand gesture of cooperation you thought might happen here, why don't we try something a little different? Been a while since I had a decent challenge. I'm taking this opportunity to show my clan how it's done.
Son of a...
Okay, so I'm a little rustier than I'd like to admit. But just a little. Felt good to be in a real scrap for once.
You got what you wanted. Time to return the favor.
Well, that would be fair, wouldn't it? So, you know the Blades went and partnered up with the Revanites. Means you probably know they're up to no good. We helped out the Blades to have a good relationship with Raiders Cove. We didn't sign up for the Revanites and their all-out war, so we bailed.
Tell me where the Revanites are, and what I'm up against.
Afraid I don't have the where to give you, but I can clue you in on the what. A whole fleet of ships they've got parked somewhere around here. I wouldn't mind it a bit if you chased the Revanites out of Rishi. Off the radar is just how we like it here. Good hunting to you, Sith. Kesush Mandoade! Who's up for a Skarkla hunt?
I understand your frustration, Jakaro, but there's only so much of your bluster I'm prepared to take.
What's going on?
Theron's been captured by the Revanites. Data from the Nova Blade hinted at the location of a Revanite safe house in Raider's Cove. We looked into it and were ambushed.
Revan knew we were here.
It looks that way. It's possible he may have sensed our presence. I couldn't say for sure. Whatever the case, I stand by my decision to not impede in Theron's abduction. And I know Theron would too. Now he's in a position to do what he does.
We're talking about a seasoned SIS operative. If the Revanites took him to their base, he could learn a lot.
Of course, if we're to make any use of that knowledge, we'll have to exfiltrate him all the same. Hopefully you fared better with the Mandalorians.
Revan has a fleet of warships on standby.
Of course. From examining the Nova Blade's data, it looks as though they've been routing Imperial and Republic fleets here to Rishi.
So the Empire and the Republic are drawn into a full-scale battle, and whoever's left standing, the Revanites pick off.
And we still don't know who we can trust. We need to interfere with the Revanites' plans, if not stop them outright.
Yes, it's true. I was able to pinpoint several communications originating from another island. I'm told there's a Rishi village on the outskirts. I can't imagine they would resent our presence there.
Then we will go there immediately and establish a base of operations for my campaign. In the end, Revan will answer to me.
Yes, my lord. We have to assume Revan's expecting a resistance force now. You should expect to find patrols along the way.
You're new.
Are you in charge here?
We don't really operate that way, but I can act as that sort of figure if you require it of me. How might I help?
My allies and I would like to stay here.
Do what you like. No Rishi will have an issue with your presence.
Reach out with your emotions. Let them guide you. Yes, that's it. Shara, tell me, what did you see?
It was you. You were in a jungle. Roots and vines, they took you, bound you, and then you were torn apart.
You saw the future. One of many possible futures, but a probable one at the very least.
Then I heard a voice. A woman, she reached out to me through the Force. She told me you had to go to Rishi.
Rishi? You said Rishi? Rishi's been coming up on the Nava computer. I thought it was some kind of glitch. Nothing out there but my kind of people.
That is no glitch. It is a message.
Let me guess. You're thinking of walking straight into a trap.
Perhaps it is a trap. What of it? Tell the crew there's been a change of schedule. I should very much like to visit this Rishi.
Wow! The rumors were true! You're here! You're really here!
You know me?
Oh, sure. I've heard you described in great detail. Great detail. You run the Howling Tempest Gang, the most daring, ruthless pirates of the Gordian Reach. Wherever that is.
I don't know what you think you've heard, but you're mistaken.
Nice try, but there's no mistake in the talk of the town. Seems like everyone in Raiders Cove is going on about you and all your insane adventures. Talk about your tough customers.
You're basic. It's very natural.
My people pick up languages and stuff real easy. Some of us like to be formal. I'm more of a cantina talk type. Speaking of cantinas, you'll want to watch for Goro. He wants to fight you so bad, it's not even funny.
What's a Goro?
Rodian. With the eyes and ears and the snout. He's a supreme something or other, I forget. Really tough for his size. Goro's at the Blaster's Path. Local watering hole. Probably washing down some Tonitron jerky with some Intellian fungo lager. I'm not allowed there anymore. Long story. So I hope someone hollows your big fight. Wouldn't want to miss a single bloody shot.
I hear you're looking for me. Or someone who fits my description, at least.
Kafsta undile, jigo hola lukuta.
Think you just did that yourself, Goro. Hang on. You're not about to wreck my place again, are you? I'm still filling in blaster holes.
Inigu daiji liskatsalanga wa. Kusa malachikuta, ikosa mose alatuta.
No, this won't be a challenge at all. Not for me.
Chonki faguta, jio bora, geoto kakise. Makipuna male tuta, od mishka.
You may be seen as a hero on Rodia, but compared to me.
You know, a few blaster marks is one thing. Gives the place some charm. But this...
You see before you a dark counselor of the Sith Empire. I should demand that you kneel. Instead, all I ask is that you give me the information I seek. Who is responsible for this ludicrous charade?
Everyone's talking about you. Couldn't tell you how it all got started, but I can tell you who gave Goro the idea to come after you.
Don't do it, Karina. You know what Margok would say about ratting out a resident?
If Margok ever pays the tab all you Nova Blades have run up, then maybe I'll start to care what he thinks. Guy you want is Kai Zykin, leader of the Corellian-run scoundrels. A real gem. Goro said Zykin owes you a pile of credits. He hired Goro to take you out for a fraction of what it would cost to pay you.
Where do I find him?
Beats me. It's not like I hang out with the guy. Ask Zykin's crew. They're all over Raiders Cove. Like stink flies.
I'm going to assume you're telling the truth. If I have to come back here, it won't be pleasant for you.
As opposed to all the pleasantness of this visit, right? Hey, I told you what I know. Best I can do. See you, Goro. Hope your brother doesn't decide this was my fault.
Well, look at this, scoundrels! A visit from...
Diaboka from Krida.
I was making a dramatic pause, Tomoda. I know it's the Hurling Tempest. Kai Zykin. I'm sure you've heard my name, most commonly accompanied by a longing sigh from one of my former conquests. Now here's the deal. The Corellian-run scoundrels may owe you a debt, but it's not coming out of my hide. Take it up with accounting.
I don't know where everyone got the idea I belong to some gang, but I'm sick of hearing it.
Wait, you're saying you're not... But that doesn't... Oh, you're just trying to confuse me.
the Akimbaba.
What? Was that a slam? Did you just slam me? Okay, alright. Listen, we can't pay. The freedom to operate in Raiders Cove isn't exactly free. After the Nova Blades take their cut, we're tapped. Not before you get an itch. I do have something of value. Something I know you want.
You tried to have me killed. I don't see why I shouldn't return the sentiment.
I get it! You're not happy with me. But you might be after this. I record all my holocalls, and that includes the one that warned me you were coming to Rishi. I'll show it to you. Tomoda, get my data pad!
Oh,
that's bad, Tomoda. That's bad. Ooh, right!
I suppose now that we've left Raiders Cove, you're going to start complaining about them instead of the pirates.
You cleared the path well, and made a friend.
I am called a Renkau.
The other inhabitants on this island, are you in contact with them? Do you know what they're up to?
If an individual Rishi chooses to get involved with others, that's that Rishi's choice. Otherwise, we tend to see no reason to inquire. These other inhabitants, they have also kept to themselves. Strangely, their encampment appears to be segregated. One group looks like her, the other is less intense.
If they have more of you in their roster, I might be joining the Revanites.
You flatter me.
If their Sith Lords are anywhere near as deadly as Lana, we're in deeper trouble than when we almost became fish food on Manan.
So there's a camp for Imperial traitors and one for Republic Revanites. And they're not exactly friends. This may provide an opportunity, either to extract atonement for their deception or to employ a little deception of our own.
It's an opportunity to thin the ranks, is what it is.
Your zeal for making heads roll never ceases to surprise me, D4. But don't worry yourself, it may yet come to that.
I'll take a closer look at these Revanite camps.
And we'll attempt to establish a better grasp of their activities.
I hope we can establish where Agent Shan is being held.
As do I.
We, Rishi, would be grateful for your help around the village. If you choose to provide it, of course. Savor your travels.
Be patient, Sergeant, but be ready. As soon as we have word from Revan, our work begins.
Lord Ivris, sir, there's... it's...
Dark Lord, how can this be?
We're found out.
I suppose Darth Maar sent you to fight his battle for him. Seems his usual way. No, better still. You learned about us and thought Maar could be in on it. You're here on your own. We have the upper hand.
When the Empire and the Republic come after you, do you really think it will end with the Revanites on top?
I fight for that in which I believe. Should I perish in service to Revan's goals, so be it.
You used to fight for something else you believed in. At least with the Empire, you stood a chance of having your efforts matter.
She makes an excellent point, my lord.
It does seem we've been less than a step ahead for some time now. Opposition at our heels and in the shadows. You'll get no further resistance from me. I can't vouch for every last Imperial Revanite, of course, but I can speak for those present.
What do you intend to do about the others?
Captain Millinex Republic contingent? Whatever your move, you'll have my fighters at your back. Ultimately, we are loyal to the Empire.
There have been reports of skirmishes in the area. I want you to stay alert for anything out of the ordinary.
Such as?
By the stars! Be ready to fire on my mark!
No, not on your mark. On mine.
You've got Ivris's people. You've turned him against the cause. Whatever you think you've accomplished, you won't stop Revan, I promise you.
You can barely hold your composure. I know you fear me.
I don't know where Revan is. Not for sure. But there's a stronghold in the valley. It's where they took Thurin Shan. I swear, it's the best information I have. And I can't ask up the chain, they'll only grow suspicious of me.
You have far outlived your usefulness, Captain. If ever you were useful to begin with. Lana, Theron's being held in a valley stronghold. Could be Revan is there as well.
I'll have D4 see what the Rishi know about it. We'll work out a plan of attack once you've returned.
I've never met a people quite like the Rishi. Pragmatic, accommodating, reasonable. If it wasn't for the climate, I'd consider staying.
I haven't had any problems with them so far.
Always be at least a little guarded. Not the worst way to live, considering all the betrayal on display. As I mentioned earlier, I did acquire some information worth noting. Rishi observations surrounding the Revanite stronghold fit what we know. They're holding powerful warships on standby, and they're well protected.
Revan actually intends to take on the Imperial and Republic fleets all at once.
It's audacious, to be sure. We've been unable to reach the Imperial fleet nearing Rishi, but I can confirm from the Nova Blade's data logs that Darth Maar's flagship is among them.
Get to work on a solution for our connection issues. He needs to know what's coming.
I'm working to remap the interference patterns into a code that protocol droids on approaching ships should be able to decipher, if they're any good.
Press on. Stall their ships if you can, and we'll do what we can from here to reach the fleet and lend support as needed.
I'm no pushover, but you aren't joking. We do hope Agent Shan is recovered.
Yes. Preferably alive. Now go show the Revanites, and, fate willing, Revan himself, why you are not to be trifled with. I'm starting to get the hang of slicing. Theron's influence, I suppose. Give me 1 second. There. A holo record of Theron under interrogation. Coordinates are coming your way.
And Revan?
No indication he's there, but no indication he isn't either. I wouldn't let my guard down.
Revan.
I should have known the Empire would send one of its lapdogs to try and find me. You should never have bothered.
What have you done with Theron?
Theron Shan's fate doesn't matter. Neither does yours. I'm changing the fate of the galaxy itself.
All I see is you trying to destroy everything.
I'm not waging some war with the Empire and Republic. I'm saving countless lives, and you keep getting in the way. The only upside in your being here, really, is that you get to bear witness. My plan's too far along for you to stop it now.
Don't listen to him. It's not over yet.
Theron, there you are.
Figured I had a lot to tell you, so I broke out. Guess I could have saved myself the trouble. Don't know how much Lana or Revan told you, but he's lured the Imperial and Republic command fleets to Rishi.
Revan wants to draw them into a fight. Try to take out the leadership.
It'll barely be a fight. Revanites embedded on both sides are gonna sabotage shields, weapons, you name it. And we can't warn them. Revan had the Nova Blades build him a signal jammer. No communications at all up in Rishi space. It'll be a bloodbath.
One call to Jakaro and no more signal jammer.
The Revanites got that thing protected. You send Jakaro out there and he and D4 become part of the landscape. This place is coming down. Soon.
You could have joined me, Theron. Understandably, you're as tenacious as I ever was. Goodbye.
Hello? Are you there?
Lana, what just happened?
I appear to have sliced through four layers of encryption to remotely deactivate the power core.
Just in the nick of time. Don't know if I could have managed that even.
Theron, good to know you're alive. I heard everything, about the jammer, all of it. We need to regroup for an immediate attack. Whatever happens, be proud of what we've accomplished up to now. See you soon.
All right, take it easy. I'm not exactly 100%, and you're not exactly gentle.
Oh, good! The team's back together again. All thanks to you for saving Theron, of course.
He's lucky I arrived when I did.
I'd hardly say this. You know what? Never mind.
Theron, you have the intelligence on this signal jammer. You start.
Right. The intelligence I gathered in the company of several interrogation probes while being held against my will? Jammer's on a near...